Hey guys, this is Eric. I've been working on a few projects using UWB so far. I hope we are on the same page. If not, please check my ESP32 plus UWB projects. In this project, I made an application that shows the distance information obtained from UWB on the screen by connecting an Android phone and ESP32. This app is currently available on Google Play, so you can download it. It's free. But in order to run this app, you need to prepare two sets of ESP32 and UWB first. One is tech device and the other one is anchor device. Tech device is the same as the ESP32 tag I made in my first project. You can easily see the distance from the tech device by connecting the anchor device on your Android phone. That's really cool. This app was made with Flutter and built for Android only. Accessing the USB serial profile from an iOS device may require inlearning in the MFI program and manufacturing a special custom cable. I gave up because this is too much work for me. If we use the connection method to BLE based instead of USB serial, we can create an app that works on iOS, but this time I made it this way. Anyway, let's have a look in more detail. My ESP32 tag is stood on the wall. This is a newly made PCB for this project. It was made by my friend John, and he's very good at making custom PCBs. You can find his Facebook group in the video description below. Take a look at his brilliant works. With ESP32 rolling 32-write, UWB and display ST7789 and ST7735 can be connected. In this project, the anchor device does not need a display, so I didn't use it. I plan to use it in other projects. This simply completes the ESP32 UWB anchor device. The source code is already uploaded. The code is very simple. It only outputs app ID, status code, and meter information to serial with JSON type. That's it. The app takes this information and displays it on the screen. This is a USB-C to micro USB adapter. It's the style of adapter commonly used in Raspberry Pi displays. This allows you to connect directly to your Android phone's USB-C port. That's all for my anchor device. You can find the source code for both anchor and tech devices in my GitHub repository. Okay, let's move on to the Android application. One second, I'm trying to start the screen recording. Okay, here we are. You don't need to run my ESP32 tag app if you have already installed this app because it works as a plug and play. Just connect your ESP32 device to your Android phone's USB port. When the device is recognized, a list of the devices that can be connected appears at the top of the screen. Tap the connect button to connect this device. Then the screen changes immediately and shows the distance from the tech device. The app is very simple because it was created for the purpose of displaying the distance data obtained from the UWB on the screen. I tried to make it looking similar to both of them. Please look at both screens. It shows the distance from each other. You can see the slight difference is due to the different timing of getting data from UWB, but I don't think it's a problem. Devices continue to send and receive signals seamlessly. What if I forcefully disconnect the anchor device from the Android phone here? The app goes back to the first screen and a question mark is displayed stating that the anchor device cannot be found even on the tech device. This is how a typical device works. You can also reconnect at any time. This is my ESP32 tag app I introduced today. If you have a chance, please try yourself. Not bad. I personally love connecting ESP32 Android phones. I think this will enable a wider variety of applications. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.